the Lilia that provides that magic damage output. So the Lunox, very great. It provides scaling, provides that, you know, basically self-peel, self-sufficient hero, and damage, magical.
Yep. Love this. All right, so Blacklist International, gonna do a little bit of a Durian in there, going for the Marksman in the mid lane. We saw this with the Nathan and the Claude from previous days. And then eventually we saw Brody adapted by one of the teams yesterday in the lower bracket. And then now it's going to be the Clint 4 for Haji. It still is very strong. So the idea that you get from the Marksman in the mid lane is you overload with damage, you clear the mid lane fast, and you participate in team fights. You make the space for this Alice. So this is a good spread coming out from the side of Blacklist International. They have physical damage from the Thames as well as the Clint, and then overload of magic damage through the Nathan as well as this Alice and Nathan, I mean.
Okay, but let's get straight into game number 3. Remember, this is match point. All Blacklist needs to do is to win this one for all the marbles, moving on to the next stage. Or will it be Cade forcing the fourth game in the series? Let's go. Break the code or go for Cade. Let's see it in the chat right now as both of the teams will get into the Land of Dawn.
I'm very curious to see how... especially for Cade, I don't want to see fundamental mistakes coming out of them, because their composition right now can play for the earlier stages of the game, and they need to take full advantage because we know how Blacklist is like. They know how to just sandbag here. But now both of their marksmen's kind of chilling here in the mid lane just to help make sure that Haji isn't going to get out pushed.
It's all about the fast clear for Blacklist International. You see that play coming up from Weiss using the skill so that they can clear the wave and go to the bottom lane.
Oh, Luiz, he's caught very bad situation, still able to get under the turn with the flicker, and that is going to force Blacklist International to move back. But look at the position of Mikey, he's in the bush. He might just go for the Jeet Kune Do onto Haji, but instant quick draw, able to get and spot around the members of Cade. Look at that, Retribution has been placed as well. Prime going in for the damage onto Weiss, and Venus almost gets taken down for both of the teams, but no one will fall. Still, Cade and Blacklist equal on the board. But maybe I'm wrong. King, he's looking for a kill onto Haji. Still able to dash away for now. It flickers out as well. And that is just a brilliant early game skirmish with zero deaths.
Haji with a good read. And overall from Blacklist International, I wonder how they were able to find out that there's someone in there. Maybe they're listening to the bushes. They're looking at their minimap. But Blacklist International will not be fooled. I also love the fact that they kind of acted like as if they don't know that there's someone out there. And they just popped the quick draw, eventually dealing the damage and poking Kid. Kid had the back down, and Blacklist International back to their usual self.
Yeah, honestly, wait, what's happening down by mid to river? It looks like Blacklist is, you know, once again, making some good reads onto Cade so far. They're not getting away with these bush tactics so far, which is great, because so far, Cade, that's one of the few advantages that they have in the early games.
Oh, wait a minute. Tekashi instantly just goes in for the death as well. Flickers in, and that's going to be Mikey for the follow-up. No damage just as of yet, but he's going to get pulled back in still with the guiding win. Beautiful by Matilda Airlines. Venus on this Matilda, just such a nuisance to the enemy team, man.
Oh, great idea from Kid. Unfortunately, Blacklist International, it's way too easy for them to get out. I mean, they managed to use the Guiding Wind, and that meant that Blacklist International easily gets out. And imagine this, that's a lot of usage, a lot of spells, as well as ultimates used by Kid. And Blacklist International, they also are taking advantage of the time that they were able to buy because of the initial movements of Kid.
Oh no! First blood already being achieved by Edward. Not what you want to see between Thamazin as well as a Baron.
Got the whole
solo kill.
Yeah, that's a solo kill. I mean, the Color Inferno for sure will be used by Edward. He knows also that the Detonus Welcome was just used in the mid lane. That meant that there will be no instant regeneration coming out from the barrels. That's why the kill potential, the kill threat, is always there.
Oh man, right now with a 1,700 gold lead, they're just building it, and that is what they do so well on. 3 minutes in the game, 30 seconds for the next turtle, and they're just playing for the setup.
How long can they play for the setup here? Because so far, I feel like Cade has been shut down in a lot of their angles when they approach these fights. A couple of things that they could look to maybe do is Mikey needs to force a play. He still has Flicker up. If he can get a good way of the dragon, he can almost guarantee a secured kill on one person. And I think most players... Oh, wait, hold on. What's happening topside?
Tekashi goes in for death as welcome. Edward, no, he's just so ruthless. Another solo kill in this game. 2 kills on the board, and all of them have been solo kills from Edward right there. Mikey, though, he might look for a pickoff, but look at Haji. He just does so much damage, forcing Prime to use that black shoes, and wow, that was brilliant. Venus goes in for the guiding wind. Haji flickers out of the way and gets in back with the dash. But look at that. King actually wants to force something here. Venus. Oh my god. Mikey goes in for the Jikundo flicker combo. Able to get away the dragon number. But it's going to be Ohem coming in and the circling eagle to finish him and silence him in that bottom side. Ohem wants some more. He's going to get some more. That is 2 for the price of nothing for Blacklist. Maybe even 3. Tekashi forced to flicker out.
Oh man. Blacklist is really feeling themselves. Now they're completely disrespecting the space that Keed is giving them. And they're going for a little bit more as well. But so far, Cade, they need to hold strong for as long as possible because right now Oheb is scaling so well into this game and Luis can only do so much. He's so item dependent.
And whatever kills that Blacklist International had in this game was off of the fact that he was kind of wasting their time in some of the parts of the map because of the map read as well of Blacklist International. So with a it is a toss-up between forced errors and good punishment coming out from Blacklist International. The macro is really not working in the favor of Keith. They went for the bottom lane. They kind of stayed in the bottom lane trying to go for a kill onto Ohib, trying to look for an opening for a flicker Jit Kundo, but wasn't able to do so. In fact, they were the ones punished in the bottom lane. And Blacklist International,
Red
they're not going to stop.
Ohib
is just styling on this. And
the
both of the side lanes are already having the better farm over their matchup.
Not just the better farm, 2-0 for both of them. Prime goes in, tries to get a kill onto Haji. Very, very aggressive here. He actually goes in all the way. Haji, he is not able to dash away, not able to get away, but maybe so. It is going to be Venus going in and bringing Ohib back into the turret. Prime popped the black shoes, so he is very vulnerable at the stage, but both teams just, you know, just choose to back away for now. That's very, very lackluster fight.
Yeah. The minions weren't already there. And guess what, man? This is just 6 minutes in. That's why teams will not overcommit on their turrets. They are not strong enough yet. But when it comes to a hero versus hero matchup, with all of the items that they were able to get, they are going to just destroy Keed at this point. The brute force breastplate for Edward already up.
Yeah, I mean, what can I say? Blacklist International just so fast to the rotations that Keed doesn't even notice until they're dead at this point. Oheb forced him back away, but this is just brilliant reads from him. He sees that Keed wants to make a play in the bottom side. Instantly just backs away. Sure, get the turret. I got the kill onto your Gelbaner. And wait a minute, it is going to be Prime forced to use the black shoes. Now Edward goes in for the flicker. Absolutely amazing guiding win once again from Venus to ensure Edward's safety as they just play the macro game. Sure, go to the bottom side. I'm just going to zone you there and take the turret.
I mean, right now, I'm with Mirko here. It's a little lackluster, unfortunately. A lot of these fights can't go further than it is, but I think at this point, it's a 7-minute first items, and even like, those who are getting far ahead, like Edward, Edward is just getting their second items too, and even Oheb at this point in time, very close. Wise, he's comfortable with the way he is. At this point, I don't think he needs a power farm anymore. He just needs to be part of these fights, and I think Cade is going to crumble under this pressure. Even Luis is making mechanical mistakes.
Oh, Haji is just such a nuisance, such a threat for Cade right now. 6-0 for Blacklist International. Let's talk about the 6,000 gold lead.
Yeah, this meant that the Ome Venus Matilda does have the Radiant Armor. He's at 3.3k. And guess what? Cade, two of their highest farmed heroes are about that level. And Blacklist International, this also means that there are 2 items present in most of their cores. Edward with War Axe as well as Brute Force Breastplate. And then Wise eventually with this Nathan is gonna hurt like a truck when they do team fight. And that is coming. 8 minutes into this game, they had to use the Way of the Dragon just to push Ohib away from the purple buff.
Oh, look at that. Tekashi caught in the midst of it all, still able to run away for now. Ohib goes in for the Flowing Blood, but it's going to be King taken very low. Wise gets a kill onto the jungler, and that is a 1-0. The fight continues as Blacklist keeps on looking for the seat. Wise goes in for the Entropy, forcing Prime to flick around, and a 7,000 gold lead with a 7-kill lead as well.
This is brutal. This is really unfortunate to watch. It's an absolute massacre here coming in for Blacklist International. They have a low kill count overall, just 7 kills, but the 8k goal lead that they've developed, and literally four turtles, well, 3 turtles now, 1 lord in the making. It's just, what do you do in Cade's position?
What do you do, Wolf? I mean, I'm speechless right now. What do you have to do? Because their composition right now, like, they needed to do something in the early stage with the Pito and the Cho, but they're simply not able to do it. Mikey is alone. Circle Eagle to go in, and that's going to be Haji following up with a guiding wind. Mikey forced them back away, but again, yes, Wolf, try to answer that question.
We'll go for the Daytona's welcome setup into the Lilia bombs and maybe use Louise in that so maybe they can get a kill. Have King peel through the back lines and have Tekashi focus on just one hero. At this point, it's the only way for Keed to win the fights. It has to be perfect. But that is not even counting the fact that Blacklist International can react easily to that.
I think the worst part about it is that that play, hard enough, the first phase of it, not too bad. You know, you could probably get the Lilia and the Smalls brought to make it happen. But to make it happen at the exact same time, to make sure that you have enough damage to get away with it. Because right now, I don't think anybody can really get, you know, kill Oheb at this point if he's like absorbing minions or at the very least just you know, have three people in his ult at that time. He just sustained through all of it.
Well, let's see what happens here. The siege is going to continue in that bottom side. A lot of range from the side of Blacklist International will be able to go in, and that's going to be Venus popping into Circling Eagle. Will just back away, and Tekashi is already chunked really, really low. Inhibitor turret number one in the bottom side taken down as Blacklist just completely rotate to the mid lane, looking for some objectives on the board.
He didn't even had a chance to fight in there. Execution from Blacklist International, despite their lead, was still phenomenal. So clean coming out from Blacklist International. For Keed, I think they're also waiting for the second item onto Louise, or maybe the third, because they had the chance to go for the quote-unquote Ruby DD play, but didn't go for it.
Surgical precision is what I like to call it for the side of Blacklist International. 7-0.
Really? Surgical precision? I'd say this is oppression. This is what it's like. Yeah. This is what it's like when you're just like trying to fight for some kind of independence here and you're just absolutely getting colonized and pushed back in towards your base. It's no fun.
Oh, Edward goes in again. And whoa, wait a minute. Venus, he is edible to bring Edward back to the base. Tekashi going in for the Deathless Welcome. We'll be able to get Venus down. And that is finally Cade on the board. But Louise will fall in turn. Mikey is next. And Blacklist, they might just look for the push right now. Is it Oheb jumping in and getting a 2-kill lead for Blacklist once more. 11-1. It was 11-0 the last game. It looks like Blacklist wants to end right here, right now. King goes in for the knockoff strike, able to zone away the minions for now, but damage keeps on coming in. Aben under the turret. The wipe out for Blacklist as they completely take over. Oppressed Brazilian team, Cade, and boom, bang, bada bing, a 3-0 clean sweep.
GG, well played to Blacklist International. They could have let King live and use that last minion to end the game, but it was just more of like, I've already set up this dictatorship. I might as well continue the oppression. What a brutal and, more importantly, just an absolute massacre of a game here. Blacklist, overwhelming power.